It's Miss Kate back again with another fun STEAM experiment for this week. And this week our experiment has to do with air pressure. So let's talk about what air pressure is. Air pressure is reference of the weight of air molecules pressing down on the earth. So you might not feel it, but at all times you have air pressing on you from all different directions. And air pressure can be determined by three things, and that is temperature, altitude, and moisture. Let's first talk about how temperature affects air pressure. Now, temperature affects it because when the air gets warmer, it expands. And this expansion is caused by the density in the air to decrease, which causes lower pressure. And when air gets cold, it shrinks. So this shrinkage causes the air to become denser, and which leads to higher pressure. So this is often can be compared to when you think about the equator of the earth. If you know anything about how the equator that goes around the middle of the earth, that is typically where it's really hot, and that has generally really low pressure because it has such warm air. While compared to places like the North and South Pole that have really high air pressure because it's really cold there. Next is altitude. Altitude affects the air pressure because the higher you are above sea level, the less dense the air is. And the less dense, the air weighs less. So it produces lower air pressure, which is why it's difficult to breathe on top of a really tall mountain. And often you have to see like hikers have to use oxygen when they reach a certain point at like, say, Mount Everest. Now this phenomenon also explains why your ears pop when you're driving down or up a mountain in a car or you're taking off in an airplane. What's happening is your inner ear has air trapped in it, and that air pressure outside decreases, so the air trapped in your ear will cause your eardrum to push forward and then expands, causing that pop noise that you hear in your ears when you're changing different altitudes. And lastly, the next thing that affects air pressure is moisture, and the amount of moisture in the air also affects the density in the air and therefore the air pressure. So water vapor is a light gas compared to the different gases in the atmosphere, which are primarily nitrogen and oxygen, and it decreases per unit of volume, which causes the density of the air to decrease. So that's how moisture also affects air pressure. So now today we're gonna do a couple different experiments just to kind of explain how all that works again, and you can see how air pressure affects us every single day. So let's get started. Alrighty guys, so for our first experiment, what we're going to do is I have here a bottle and I have here a hard-boiled egg, and the goal of the experiment is to try to get the egg into the bottle. So as you can see here, without smushing it, it just kind of stops at the top and it doesn't go all the way down. So I have it and it doesn't work. So what we're gonna do is we're going to use air pressure to push the egg and suck it into the bottle. And there's two different ways that we can do this. We can go it this way and we can go it this way, and I can show you both options. And how we're gonna do this is we have to make the air pressure inside of the bottle lower than the air pressure outside of the bottle. So going back to what we were talking about earlier about how temperature affects air pressure, we have to think again about how the warmer air expands, and this expansion causes the density in the air to decrease, which causes lower pressure. So how we're gonna make the air pressure in the bottle lower is we're going to make it warmer. So what I'm gonna do here is I do have some matches, so if you're doing this experiment at home, make sure you have an adult with you. I'm going to light it on fire, put it in there, and put our egg on top, and there we have it. So I set a piece of paper on fire inside the bottle, which caused the air pressure to lower. So that lower air pressure sucks the egg down into the bottle. Now there is another way you can do this egg in the jar experiment, and that is sucking the egg upwards into the bottle. So how to do this is you still have to make the air pressure in the bottle warmer so that the air pressure lowers and sucks it up. So how this is gonna work is we are going to take two candles here, and I'm going to put them into my egg. And again, I'm gonna light it on fire so that it creates warmth inside the bottle to suck it up. I'm going to go ahead and add another candle and stick it into my egg. So then I'm going to put the jar over the candle and the egg and put it up And there we go. It also sucks the egg up into the jar. So once again, that is that lower pressure being built in the egg so that the higher pressure pushes the egg up into the bottle. I guess you can call this an excellent experiment. Alrighty guys, so I do have another experiment for you, and what you're gonna need for this one is you're going to need a jar and an index card. And I have one of the bigger size index cards because you wanna make sure that your index card covers the whole top of your jar. And what you're gonna do now is you're gonna wanna be near a sink. So I'm right here in front of my kitchen sink, and you're gonna wanna fill your jar up all the way to the very, very top. So you wanna make sure that your water is all the way up to the very, very rim of your jar. And what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna take your index card and you're gonna cover the top of your jar. So after you have it covered all good, you're gonna take the top of your hand and you're gonna cover it again. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna very fast flip the jar upside down so that the index card is pressed to the top of your jar. So it's gonna be like this. So what you should have seen happen is all the air in the jar is now gonna be at the very top here. And what you can do now is when you have it steady, is you can remove your hand from the bottom of the jar. And so what's happening here is just like that egg in the jar experiment, the air pressure inside your jar with the water is lower than the air pressure that is on the outside of the jar. So that really high pressure, again, is pushing up on that index card and keeping it in place so that the water in the jar does not fall out, because the air pressure that's in here is lower and the air pressure that is out here is strong enough to hold up that jar of water also. All right, I hope you have fun with those two experiments. I do have another fun kind of demonstration activity that you can do at home also that helps you better understand air pressure. And what you're gonna need for that is I have here a plastic bottle that actually has a tiny hole in the bottom of it that I poked in the bottle. And then I have a balloon around the neck of the bottle. And to better understand air pressure, what I want you to do is I want you to go ahead and blow into the balloon when your finger is not covering the hole in the bottle. So go ahead and try that. As you can see, that just happened is the balloon in the bottle has blown up. Now try it again, but this time cover that hole that is in your bottle with your finger and see what happens. It doesn't work, right? Why do you think that is? So what's happening in your bottle is that when you have that hole in your bottle, it is allowing air movement. So it is allowing air to be pushed out of the bottle, which allows room for air to be blown into your balloon so that it has room to expand. But when you cover that hole, it's sealing the inside of your balloon, so it's not allowing air to move out. So that way when you blow into it, it's not allowing it to expand. Another thing that you can do also is you can suck the air out of the bottle and see what happens to your balloon. So like this. So as you can see there, when I sucked the air out of the bottle, it caused the balloon to also inflate. And what this demonstration shows is how air takes up space and how there's this constant movement of push and pull between high air pressure and low air pressure. And even though we can't see it around us, it's constantly happening. And this also affects stuff such as weather around us also. Alrighty guys, I hope you had fun with today's experiments and now have a better understanding of air pressure and how air pressure works. Remember, if you're doing these experiments at home, to make sure you have an adult with you, especially the ones that require fire today. So remember to stay safe doing your experiments and have fun with it. So I will see you again next week, and thanks for watching. Bye.